June, Silverdi, a mysterious creator who called himself the Dread Pirate Roberts, was transacting in millions and millions of dollars worth of narcotics.
I want to explain to people who don't visit the dark web, the Silk Road is just the name of a website, right? But it's one that you can visit without being traced yourself, or you thought you could visit without being traced.
But the dark web was years old technology. I mean, it never seemed like it was possible before to do e-commerce on the dark web, because it seemed like any kind of PayPal or contactless credit cards that you used could easily be traced. But Bitcoin changed that and opened up this new world where the Silk Road and its many, many drug dealers believed that they could do millions of dollars worth of narcotics deals and nobody could follow them.
You interviewed at one point, I believe, the person who identified himself as the Dread Pirate Roberts, and he described this not just as a way to make money illicitly, but a kind of ideology. What's the ideology?
Well, the Dread Pirate Roberts, who turned out to be this 29-year-old tech savant named Ross Roberts, he didn't have a kind of ideology of victimless crime, and he saw Bitcoin as the secret ingredient that was going to allow him to launch a revolution where the states, in the capital assets, he puts it, would be one to be able to control what people thought and sold or put in their bodies or all sorts of other things you could do with a truly untraceable money, as he believed it was.
Many of the recipients are identified only by some random string of letters and numbers. Here's our producer, Katie Klein, reading such a string.
15G7SAGS.
Understandably, Andy Greenberg himself used to think there was no way to track a transaction.
There was this kind of slow motion.